know our parents have been shitty, but we can't just leave them. That doesn't sound like Cole Price. Wouldn't it hurt your mom? She doesn't deserve that, right? I don't deserve to live in the middle of my parents' city. Right. Of course you don't. Fine then, Jonathan. Where are we going? You tell me. What you need to do with your patient is prototyping for a great one. Why don't you go to LA? Perfect. 60 degrees every night. You and me on the sand lot. Boiling on the food truck floor. Smoking up. Looking at me and me. Like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
Dude, should we just rub that off the fuck? What?
This is temporary. The deal is, you get it done for real. Then, I'll believe you. What if I said we'll see you tonight? Really? What is this?
Smile. No.
Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff for my house. For you or for me? I gotta say, my clothes are damn good.
Cool.
Let's do it. And then, we'll get the hell out of here. So, yes. Mm-hmm.
Rose. Rachel's home. And she brought her new friend.
Our star returned. You're just in time.
Dinner's almost ready.
Funny, was it?
Nailed it. I must have been pretty memorable.
You were.
I get the sense that you're used to making an impression.
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
So, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must?
I must?
Of course.
I made chicken on the plate. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
Thanks. But I was just gonna stop in for a sec and then bounce.
Oh, did you have other dinner plans?
Dinner plans?
I always thought dinner was something that just sort of happens.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please?
Of course.
Great. I just need to wash off.
Then we'll be right down.
Don't be long. In the meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, please?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber.
Okay, I'm Mabel. After dinner, we can make a break. Can you pull down here?
Totally, yeah. Your parents love me.
They're good at coming off that way, but don't let your guard down. And Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know,
that I would normally say.
Exactly.
Just some quality time with the Ambers.
What the fuck? What's really going on? Rachel really was an overachiever before she met me.
Glad I had that in the bud.
So this is what normal looks like. Somehow way more boring and way weirder than I imagine. It's crazy to picture Rachel coming up here and being happy here, at least before she met me. And now I'm taking her away. Or is she taking me away? This doesn't really seem like the kind of place people run away from. Let me say, fuck this place. Doing the play is bad enough without having to read about it afterwards. How to clear browser history. Followed by a gap for all of yesterday. That's like cheating asshat in 101. Poor Rachel. Easy to see who wears the literary pants around here. Some families actually go to Paris instead of just talk about it their whole lives. Everything about this house is nicer, cleaner, better, and more expensive than mine. Which isn't saying much, but classes. Yeah, the numbers are fancy as shit. Never realized that getting drunk could be so complicated. Oh, I think that's an original Who Gives a Shit.
So jealous.
Rachel and I both had great childhoods. Mine just ended all a little before hers, I guess. No skeletons. Lots of shiny dishes, though. Hey there, Mrs. Amber. Really, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight. What do you think of the play? Rachel was typically amazing, but I never liked The Tempest. What did you think of? To be honest, I only really read a couple pages. Theater's not really my thing. I guess I'm not so into seeing words someone else came up with. Fair point. Then again, I'm not sure you can judge the entire art form based on dead white men your curriculum focuses on. Yeah, that's fire, Shakespeare. Integrity, honesty, loyalty. What? It's on your lawn. Oh, right. Sorry. I guess I'm still getting used to being an elected official's wife. What's it like being married to the DA? Much like being married to anyone else, I imagine. But with a lot more secrets, right? Secrets? Like attorney, client privilege, and all that. Well, as district attorney, he brings cases against criminals on behalf of the state. He doesn't defend them. Of course not. So, Rachel was pretty awesome tonight. Yes, she was. Though, to be fair, she's pretty awesome every night. I wish I were half as driven when I was her age. Me too. I get the sense that you're a force of nature yourself. I can see why the two of you get along so well. You can? Because it still seems crazy to me. So, you putting me to work or what? Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table. Hey, what if I can't? Excuse me? You said if I could. Anyway. You're right, Chloe. Alright, Chloe, you've set the table without ruining someone's marriage before. Please. And stuff to the table with you.
Wow, but no.
Hi, Mr. Amber.
Whoa, what can I do?
So, you're a district attorney, huh?
I'm your district attorney.
So, I can call you if I'm ever district arrested?
What would you be arrested for?
It was a joke. Not a good one, clearly. What do you think? I thought Rachel was perfectly cast.
She certainly was. We were very proud of her. I had no idea they were going to do that.
What?
I don't know the name for it. The first casting, casting a woman as a man?
I just meant the wizard part.
I suppose that's also true.
Your daughter's pretty great.
Thank you. We're talking.
You ever feel like she's so awesome and everything that you just wanna shake her? Yeah. Me neither. Duty calls. Good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Mommy? Please, check. Anything else? Actually, could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink for dinner? I will be a dear. Talking to James. As long as I can avoid using the words cheating and scumbag, I should be fine.
Something else?
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
I'm sorry?
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's say sherry.
Okay. One, two, three, sherry. Oh. Besides all my bad behavior, rubbing off on her, you mean?
Another joke.
You tell me. It seemed like you and Wells were happy to believe that this morning.
And you were all too eager to play into our expectations. In my experience, that's a tactic people use to cover for someone else. Rachel is her own person. She's responsible for her actions. I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
Thanks. They say all news is local, but damn. Yes, honey? The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you.
The glasses are on the china cabinet. You can place one at his end.
How am I supposed to get to China?
Kidding. It's a fancy looking cabinet, right?
You got it.
It's the triangle, pick one.
basic shapes. Now you're speaking my language.
The fuck? Just gonna put one glass.
Yes, Mommy?
What else? Feel like I'm getting good at this. Only one last step. As our guest, you may do the honor of lighting the candle. The lighter is in my cape. I've got my own. Oh. You never know when you'll need to light a candle. Right? You are a paragon of preparedness. Thanks. Light some candles and pass this joint up a bit. The Amber family and fire. What could possibly go wrong? So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes? Not since this morning.
Oh, gosh. I'm so sorry.
Nah, that's cool. We're not.
What about that fire?
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
Yeah, it's scary. After those floods upstate, I was overjoyed we had less rain this year. Who knew a spring drought could be even more dangerous? You never know where a deadly spark will come from.
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson? Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family. Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Should I attack him, bro? Yep. Let's attack him.
Enough of this asshole. Rachel may have to take it, but I don't. I'm going to turn his daughter and wife against him at his own dinner table.
I'm not sure I agree, James.
Oh? I thought you, of all people, would be grateful for family, at least.
Gratitude seems like such a nice luxury. I can't say I've had the privilege to afford it.
That is an excellent point, Chloe. We must always be sensitive to the way our privileges shape our perspectives.
Well said, Mom.
Still, there must be some room for personal responsibility. I'm sure you agree, Chloe.
I don't know why I said this.
What is this? An interrogation? Am I on trial? Maybe I should turn this table around and start lobbing some brain busters at you.
Now, Chloe, there's no need to turn heated during a friendly discussion.
Agreed.
Yeah, what the fuck, dude? Pussies, bro.
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
I wish. Rachel's all honors. I'm still trying to get into remedial. What's it called? Vocabulary. What about that fire? Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
It's almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crown of passion.
Passion? What does that mean?
I don't know. You tell me. Because you're the DA, of course.
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson? Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family. Family is not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Enough of this asshole. Rachel may have to take it, but I don't. I'm going to turn his daughter and wife against him at his own dinner table. I'm not sure I agree, James.
Oh? I thought you of all people would be grateful for family, at least.
Gratitude seems like such a nice luxury. I can't say I've had the privilege to afford it.
That is an excellent point, Chloe. We must always be sensitive to the way our privileges shape our perspectives.
Well said, Mom.
Still, there must be some room for personal responsibility. I'm sure you agree, Chloe.
My dad was super responsible. He always drove under the speed limit. Then one day, a truck came along and turned him into a super responsible pancake.
What?
See? This is why it's so important to invite diverse voices to converse with one another. It's absolutely stimulating. Highly stimulating.
Since you have answers for everything, Chloe, perhaps you'd like to enlighten us with some of your hard-earned wisdom about the world.
Wake up.
Sure. I believe the entire world is a simulation to keep us complacent while machines harvest our energy like a giant battery. I call this simulation Sleepy Battery Planet.
Measures.
I'm confused.
Yes. Chloe, I believe your point was a bit too veiled for me to understand.
Are you you suggesting that I'm using some sort of incognito mode where I can keep my activities hidden? That's crazy.
Excuse me? How dare you talk to me like this?
Talk to you like what? I don't understand.
Yeah, Dad. What is Chloe talking about?
Nothing.
I should stop again. Losing my sanity.
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
I wish. Rachel's all honors.
Why can't you skip this shit?
I'm still trying to get into remedial. What's it called? Vocabulary. What about that fire? Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it. Yeah, it's scary. After those floods upstate, I was overjoyed we had less rain this year. Who knew a spring drought could be even more dangerous?
You never know where a deadly spark will come from.
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson? Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family. Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Nothing is
asked
of me. Rachel may have to take it, but I don't. I'm going to turn his daughter and wife against him at his own dinner table. I'm not sure I agree, James.
Oh, I thought you of all people would be grateful for family, at least.
Gratitude seems like such a nice luxury. I can't say I've had the privilege to afford it.
That is an excellent point, Chloe. We must always be sensitive to the way our privileges shape our perspectives.
Well said, Mom.
Still, there must be some room for personal responsibility. I'm sure you agree, Chloe.
My dad was super responsible. He always drove under the speed limit. Then one day, a truck came along and turned him into a super responsible pancake.
See, this is why it's so important to invite diverse voices to converse with one another. It's absolutely stimulating. Highly stimulating.
Since you have answers for everything, Chloe, perhaps you'd like to enlighten us with some of your hard-earned wisdom about the world.
Sure. I believe there's always darkness in this world, and it usually comes from the people we thought we could trust.
Very well articulated, Chloe. I am consistently impressed with how politically aware your generation is.
Chloe is an excellent articulator.
Excuse me, dear? But if this is what passes for politically aware these days, we're in serious trouble.
James! That's unfair and also rude to Chloe.
No, I don't believe it is. It seems clear that these points Chloe is making are merely veiled attacks on me.
Are you suggesting that I'm using some sort of incognito mode where I can keep my activities hidden? That's crazy. Don't worry, Mr. Amber. I can tell that my progressive attitude is not welcome in this house. I'll see myself out.
James, Chloe is right. You owe her an apology.
I owe her no such thing. I believe she is willfully acting belligerently, just as she did this morning. It is how people like her respond to adversity.
People like her? So we're profiling now? This is what 8 months in the DA's office has taught me.
I resent that. My office is committed to fair and equitable treatment.
Yes, I've read the press releases.
Excuse me? Are you calling me a hypocrite? Rachel!
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit and...
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad! You're a hypocrite! Okay? I know! You lying, cheating, piece of shit, motherfucker!
Excuse me?
We saw you yesterday at the Overlook.
James?
Kissing that woman.
James.
Rachel, honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
No offense, Mr. Amber, but I think we trust our eyes more than you.
That's enough. You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I knew exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of
you. Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
That's enough, James. I will not have you confused.
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Damn. Some juicy gossip, I like. It was so obvious though, right? Because they're both blonde.
Most of us are heathen.
Okay, let's see. You asked Rachel for a kiss. So stupid, right? Okay, you took the blame for Rachel. Yeah. You refused. Bro, what is wrong with people, bro? What is wrong with these human beings, man? That's not the outfit we was wearing, bro. I'm not wearing the outfit, bro. Okay, next episode starting in 7 seconds. How is empty? The devil's on here. Who says it was preaching nature, right?
For gaming. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
I don't know why I like the fucking money!
Joey Hess is way late. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our area.
No fucking chance. I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are near, Prologue. What sayest thou? To my most hopeful wish. Yes. Let's leave. For real. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen. What would it take to convince you?
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Yeah, it was so basic, it was so easy to understand.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Of course. In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah. Your birth.
Okay, so what? That doesn't explain why you still think.
I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Yes.
You can do it, bro. You're okay, bro.
We're pursuing college, careers, families. Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape. When Sarah became pregnant, choice. I was never going to let her harm you again.
Are you any harm this so no. No, yeah, why did you do this though?
But you saw at the Overlook. Rachel. It was true. You kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss. Goodbye. I told her. And I was happy for her. But she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done.
She wants to come back.
But after all the people she hurt. All the lies. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world. A chance to be your mother.
And she threw it.
And she squandered it. hurt her like that. But I do again. And again. And again. To keep you safe.
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
When I left Sarah, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. Like, people change, right?
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Rachel, I think I need to lie down. I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
How about Steve and I just got the house? Can we actually leave? No, we cannot leave. Why can't we leave, bro? Like, you know, I can't be arsed with this shit.
Holy shit. Rachel completely destroyed that table. Some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her. I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't. Weird. May you always be safe.
Just taking shit. Yoink.
This light needs more light.
you switch off the light.
I wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that we were so close to making our break last night. Now? I don't know. I can't imagine what Rachel is thinking right now. I want her to tell me when she's ready. Hey, Rachel. I'm glad you're here, Chloe. Of course. Light show. But it kind of makes sense that Rachel needs two signs to contain her awesomeness. I shall call her Lion Crab from now on. Rachel's surrounded by so much love, yet she seems so
ungrateful.
Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp look cool. Rachel has so many inspirations, she can barely keep them all contained. Is there a section on how to walk fours through batshit crazy family drama? No? I think Rachel could use another subject.
But which one?
Her money. What?
That's the one. Rachel's really into stars. I wonder if it's her way of feeling connected. Even you, Willie, couldn't come up with the tragedy Rachel's going through. Maybe I can make the world a less scary place. Back on the train, I said,
we just fucking up that whole room.
I've heard that Rachel and Nathan hang out sometimes, but it still seems hard to believe. I just thought you might like it. I've always loved stars. It reminds us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see.
Never will see.
I had a hunch. Then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years.
It's called a dwarf star.
They're old lies. But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right? don't know. They're not even real. What's the point?
Bro, we're in the Matrix. What are you talking about? Funny, you know.
All lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. I can't even call her that anymore. And that other woman, my real mom, is the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think there's the only one in the world that I can trust. I don't know. I bet there's like one other chick in Australia who's super trustworthy. No chance. You're one in 100 infinities, Chloe Price.
Dude, it's been 2 days, bro. This is like Elsa. Like Frozen.
I wore this bracelet my entire life.
So fake.
I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone.
Sights that bright led to my be. I like to move right with me, baby. No, I got that good. Bro, I just don't know how I'm not fucking, like, I am the most... I am the specimen. For the money, man. Come on.
I think I need to see her. Is that wrong? Of course not. She might be tough to track down. Yeah. That's true. Luckily, I've got my secret weapon.
What's that?
What if we can't find her? So like I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start. I think I know what to do. I'll calm Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
We'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
Ah, oh, they are here.
Don't worry. I've got that one covered too.
You do?
Yeah. In fact, anything you could come up with, I'll handle it.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I didn't know how to keep talking to him. I still don't. But it doesn't matter. All that matters is that he's there. Your dad? He's there. It's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Where is that? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real.